Mataji's. Translation: The Brahmana spoke as follows. Oh, what great misfortune! I have simply tormented myself uselessly, struggling so hard for money that was not even intended for religious or material enjoyment. Text number 15. Prayanartha kadaryanam na sukhaya kadachan iham chatma patapaya murtasya narakaya cha. Translation: Generally, the wealth of misers never allows them any happiness in this life. It causes their self-torment, and when they die, it sends them to hell. Sorry, word miski. Word meaning. From the text number 14, there are two shlokas, 14, 15. Sa, he, cha, and. Spoke, idam, this, aho, alas, kashtam, the painful misfortune, vritha, vainly, atma, the self, me, my, anutapita, distressed, na, not, dharmaya, for religiosity, na, nor, kamaya, for sense gratification, yasya, whose, artha, for wealth, ayesha, labor, idrisha, such as this. There is no purport to shloka number 14. There is a, however, one line purport in text number 15, purport by disciples of His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. A miser is afraid to spend his money even for obligatory religious and social duties. Offending God and people in general, he goes to hell. Om Agyanat Mirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshur Unmilitam Yena Tasmai Sri Guru Emanma Sri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupam Gadamayam Tadati Swapadantikam He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpa Taruvhishya Kripa Sindhu Vevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavhebhyo Namo Nama Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prashtaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namine Namaste Saraswati Deve Auravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Pashat Deshatarine Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Srivasadi Gaura Bhaktavrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna. I thank you all of you for giving an opportunity to render service by having discussion on Bhagavatam. There is one beautiful shloka in the Bhagavad Gita, all of you must be knowing, 13th chapter, text number 26. And this shloka I am going to tell because that's what, I mean, my preparation is all about. Anne teva ajananta shutvanyebhya upasate tepich atitaranti eva murtu shruti parayana. And translation goes like this. Again, there are those who, although not conversant in spiritual knowledge, begin to worship the Supreme Person upon hearing about Him from others. Because of their tendency to hear from authorities, they also transcend the path of birth and death. And Prabhupada in purport, he writes, this verse is particularly applicable to modern society because in modern society, there is practically no education in spiritual matters. This hearing process is very important. Lord Chaitanya, who preached Krishna consciousness in the modern world, gave great stress to hearing, because if the common man simply hears from authority to sources, he can progress. Especially according to Lord Chaitanya, if he hears the transcendental vibration, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. And then he further writes, it is stated therefore that all men should take advantage of hearing from realized souls and gradually become able to understand everything. Then worship of the Supreme Lord will then undoubtedly take place. So this is practically applicable to my life because it's not that this opportunity given to speak on the Bhagavatam, I know anything apart from, you know, some basics like, you know, why we should practice Krishna consciousness or why, you know, one should practice, you know, spiritual path, some basics. But by hearing from authoritative sources, we can understand many things. And even most of the time, we can save a lot of time. Apart from that, Prabhupada also writes that although common man is not often as capable as so-called philosopher, but faithful hearing from an authoritative person will help one transcend this material existence and go back home, back to God. Like today morning when I was preparing in the office, Prabhuji came and some recording was going on there. You know, Maharaj lecture. I thought Maharaj is giving some lecture in the temple hall. Then I came outside to see just, you know, if some Maharaj is giving some address or what. And then I came to know that Prabhuji is there and he's hearing some, you know, lecture on his, some device is there. And somebody was telling that some Mataji asking question to Maharaj. The senior devotees, they say, we should not hear Bhagavatam, something like that. And then I heard that, I said, I have to first prepare. And then I went inside. Like that, so this hearing process will enable us to practice, and also if, you know, we are told to render this service of, you know, having some discussion on Bhagavatam, that can also be facilitated by just hearing from authoritative sources. That is also confirmed in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. As we practice Krishna consciousness, this is also not only, you know, to nourish ourselves, but also, you know, just like now the service is given, I have to speak. That also facilitates and also for myself, and when it is required, I can share it with others also. Mali hana kare sei bija aropan, shavana kirtana jale karaye sechan. This is Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya, 19th chapter. And then he says that if we are not able to hear and chant, there can be one reason, it is due to an offense. And this is described in the next verse. Yadi Vaishnava Aparadha, Ute Hati Mata, Upade Va Chinde, Tara Sukhi Yai Pata. So many of the times we, you know, our hearing and chanting process, if it goes down, then we have to check it again back. That if, you know, I done some, you know, committed some mistakes. Tata Mali Yatna Kari Kare Avarana Aparadha Hastira Yaiche Na Haya Udgam. So we have to take care by guarding ourselves, by remaining in the association of the devotees. And Prabhupada writes that even if one thinks that there are many pseudo-devotees or non-devotees in the Krishna consciousness society, this is even if you think, it's not like that, but if we think, Then he says there still one should stick to the society. If one thinks the society's members are not pure devotees, one can keep direct company with the spiritual master. And if there is any doubt, one should consult the spiritual master. By associating with non-devotees, one breaks the regulative principles and is thereby lost. And then he quotes Rupa Goswami's, you know, that shloka, Atyahara Prayashasya Jana Sangasya Lolasya. So like that, this is the background of my preparation. So nothing, you know, great or anything I know about Bhagavatam, but just what I have heard from Maharaj or Prabhupada and all the senior devotees, especially I like to hear Chaitanya Charan Prabhu. From him I heard, you know, many lectures. So whatever I have assimilated, I will try to share according to the purport as it goes. So if we come to the today's purport, there not much purport, just one line, two lines. I was wondering what to share. It says that the miser afraid to spend his money even for obligatory religious and social duties. Offending God and people in general, he goes to hell. So I'll try to speak about one topic. I just, you know, try to give it a name. Investment in Krishna is the greatest investment. We'll try to see how we can invest in Krishna and what are the obstacles. So there are four, you know, points I'll discuss. First of all, as the purport goes, it demonstrates the value of the human life. Second, I'll discuss, as it purport mentions, that it is obligatory religious duties. So it mentions why religion is obligatory for the human society. And third, I'll discuss why people, you know, they don't come forward to invest in the religious matters. What is the reason and how we can overcome that? And lastly, we'll discuss what are the four requirements for investment in Krishna, or investment in any religious process, or investing in God consciousness. So the first point here, it goes like that. The shloka mentions, you know, this Avanti Brahmana, who is, you know, Yugavatar Prabhu, you know, gave a long list of different type of beggars. One time I was coming from book distribution, I also met one beggar. Just he was sharing so many examples, so I thought I'll share at least one example. One time, this is in 2012 when we were in BT under guidance of Shadbhuj Prabhu. So that time, as I was coming from, you know, evening book distribution through this road from Grand Road, while coming here, I met one person. He was looking well-to-do person with nice, you know, dress, but he was sitting on the ground. And then I asked him, do you want, you know, any book? I think I had Ishopanishad. Then he said, yes, give me. Then I just gave him and said, give me money. It was something 25 rupees, 20 rupees at that time. Then he said, but I don't have money. So my usual practice was whenever somebody, you know, they don't have money, I would ask someone who is passing by, Are Baba, iske liye kuch sponsor karo. He is asking. This is kind of Shastradan. So I asked, you know, some person was passing by and I asked him that this fellow wants, you know, this book to read. Can you sponsor 25 rupees? He then thought for some time and then he said, okay, I'll give. He gave 25 rupees. And then I took the money and gave him that book. And as soon as that person, you know, goes ahead, the one who sponsored the Lakshmi, that the person who is supposed to, you know, get the book and then do next whatever he is going to read or keep it with him. But then he says that, now give me your 25 rupees. I said, what? He said, see, you got the money, right? And either you want money or you want book, right? So you take the book and give me money. I said, it can't be done like that. He sponsored book for you. If I do like that, I'll get karma and you also get karma. But he said, no, but at least you should give me 50%. I said, come on, this is not a business. He said, see, it is only because of me you got this deal. So there are such kind of people also, and this is the adventure of book distribution. Many times if you go on book distribution, you can experience that. Now as the marathon is coming, of course I'm not advertising, but you can experience many such things. Another time I remember I was traveling, you know, in a train and giving books to some people. And then one person that Gaurangpu always says, nah, that the problem is not that, you know, I have, Krishna has, you know, thousands of wives or queens. Problem is I don't have even one. I heard that many times in a lecture. During that time, Prabhuji used to, you know, tell, you know, these things in the lecture. Nowadays, I don't know whether he tells or not. So one person, he was taking book, and then he suddenly became little, you know, abnormal, and he started saying that, what your Krishna, what your this, your dharma, religion, on all that. He is, you know, having so many extramarital affair and this and that. And then he started saying all this, you know, stuff. Then I said that, because that time very new and very, so running blood, hot blood. So I said, I think you don't have even one. So he said, I have two. So, and then he became very angry and started telling so many things. I immediately get down and went to the next train. So nowadays, I remember sometime these adventures having during book distributions. So like that, but this Avanti Brahmana is not an ordinary bhikshu. He's having, you know, he has got the realization that whatever I had is, you know, simply it was not being used for either sense gratification or neither it was used for religious purpose. So like that. So this shloka goes on two parallel lines when it gives the lesson. One is at the level of material religiosity, or you can say at the material level, if we have any assets or something, sometimes we have, you know, some stuff in our locker and we don't either use or give to others. They're just lying there for so many years. So this is a kind of anartha which actually we have to overcome. So this one tendency at the material level, that we are neither using it for, you know, our own gratification of the senses, and second, it talks also about the value of the human life, that how, although having this nice facility of human, you know, birth, still we are not using it for higher cause. So these two parallel, you know, goes here. And in purport, there is a, and in the shloka also, there is word this, you know, kripana, miser. We have heard this many times, even in the Bhagavad Gita, and, you know, in the, even in the beginning, second chapter, I think, Prabhupada mentions the definition of a miser. And in one lecture given at the University of Divinity School, Cambridge, Prabhupada mentions that in the Garga Upanishad, it is said, etad vidya, etad viditva ya prayati sa brahmana, etad viditva ya prayati sa kripana. Brahmana means broad-minded liberal, so one who, everyone will die. The cats and dogs and human beings, everyone will die. But the Garga Upanishad says that if one dies after understanding the science of God, then he is perfect. He is Brahmana, his life is broader. And if one dies without understanding this, he is Kripana, miser. Miser means, suppose if you have got millions of dollars, if you cannot utilize it, if you simply waste it, then you are Kripana, miser. You do not know how to spend money. Similarly, we have got this body which is worth not millions, trillions, and more than that. Because we can realize in this life what is our relationship with the God. Like that, there are many quotations in the Bhagavatam. When Chanaka Pandit is one quotation, Prabhupada quotes here, Dhanani jivitam chaiva pararthe pradne mrtyu sajid. Sannimitte varam tyago vinashe niyate sati. At the time of death, anyway, it's going to get wasted if we are not used. So better use it before death comes. So like that, there are many shlokas, two, three shlokas I'll quote here. One shloka in the 11th canto, 20th chapter, 17th shloka. Nurdehe madhyam sulabham sudhurlabham plavam sukalpam guru karanadharam mayanu kulena nabhasvateritam puman bhavabdim nataretsa atmaha. One who is, even after having this human body, which is compared to a boat, and this, you know, if there is a boat, then there has to be some navigator who, you know, drives that boat. That is captain. That is spiritual master. And then there are favorable winds. The similar shloka about the boat comes in the Bhagavad Gita. Indriyanam hi charatam yanmano anvidhiyate tatasya hrati pradnyam vayur navam ivam bhasi. I'm just giving that another example to, you know, tell that when the boat is in the ocean, it is understood that boat is intrinsically in a vulnerable position, but it can, you know, if not, you know, taken proper care, it can either sink or just go in different directions which are not favorable. So therefore, this favorable wind, which are the Vedic literature or scriptures, if we don't take, you know, benefit of them, then our boat will go in different directions. So like that, there are two winds. One is the favorable, other is unfavorable. So like that, we can compare it to either Yoga Maya or Mahamaya. Mahamaya is the material, you know, literatures. That is material wind, which is unfavorable. And Yoga Maya is the spiritual wind, which is spiritual literatures. The more we place ourselves in the spiritual literatures or spiritual, you know, society or favorable winds, to that extent, it becomes very easy to practice Krishna consciousness. Otherwise, if we divert our attention to mundane literatures or mundane things, then it becomes difficult, you know, what to speak up. Even just moving along the direction becomes, you know, difficult to start also. So this shloka is there. And then the other shloka that day, Yugatara Prabhu quoted, Labdhva sudhar labham idam bahu sambhavante manushyam arthadam anityam apiha dhira trunam yatetana patet anumrtu yavan nishaya syas vishaya khalu sarvat syat. That sense gratification is available even to, you know, base animal, you know, low animals, low class animals. And one lecture I was hearing, Prabhupada's lecture, I'll just read out. One Hindi lectures I, you know, sometime hear, and some points I have written down. It's a little, you know, harsh to hear that, but it is required so that our material conceptions can be smashed. So this he says, इतना कष्ट करके इंद्रिय तर्पण करे तो वो सुअर का काम है. सुअर दिन भर रात भर घूमता है, परिश्रम करता है, कि इसलिए कहाँ गू है. वही बात हुआ, गू उसका खाद्य द्रव्य है, उसके लिए दिन रात परिश्रम करता है, और हमारा खाद्य द्रव्य गू नहीं है, कोई और है. अगर वो गू नहीं है तो गू बनने वाला है. ऐसे चीज़ के लिए हम परिश्रम कर रहे हैं, जो खाएंगे हलवा पूरी वो गू बन जाएगा. जो सुअर जो है वो गू बनने से खाता है और हम गू बनाने के लिए खाते हैं, उसमें क्या फ़र्क है. कोई कहेगा हम तो लूची पूरी खाते हैं, तो लूची पूरी तो गू बनेगा, इसके बाद सुअर खाएगा. तो हमारा जीवन सुअर के जैसा कष्ट करने के लिए नहीं बना है. कष्ट करो जरूरत है जितना, आहार निद्रा भय मैथुन, पर असल बात मत भूलो. इतना सुअर गधा तुम हो गया कि असली बात भूल गया. सुअर गधा पहले से ही था, इसीलिए तुमको इंसान देवता बनाने के लिए ये वर्णाश्रम धर्म है. सो लाइक इट्स लिटिल टफ टू हियर, बट देन इट इज रिक्वायर्ड सम टाइम, एंड ओनली प्रभुपाद कैन से लाइक दैट. सो दिस इज दैट वन कोटेशन. सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट पॉइंट. दिस एम्फसाइजेस द वैल्यू ऑफ द ह्यूमन लाइफ, हाउ इट इज वैल्यूएबल, एंड वी शुड यूज इट फॉर, यू नो, प्रॉपर, you know, reason. The second point in the purport, it is mentioned the religion is obligatory for the human being. There are, you know, it also mentions obligatory social and religious duties. So I'll not talk about the social duties, but about the obligatory religious duties. And why it is obligatory? Because that is the main function of the human being. Like that shloka goes, we quote many time in the beginning JOSD courses, but we should remember this all the time, over and over again. Ahara nidra bhaya maitunam cha samanya itat pashubhi naranam dharmo hi tesho tesham adhiko vishesho dharmena hina pashubhi samana. That these four elements that we eat, sleep, we defend, and we mate, these are common between ordinary animals and human beings, like Prabhupada was telling in this quotation. And if we don't rise above that, then what is the difference between, you know, human being and an animal? There has to be some difference. At least, you know, we insult ourselves by not rising to above that level. Such an insult to human being who has, you know, got such, you know, higher intelligence. And as far as we go to the, you know, religion, there are three broad categories. Bhagavad Gita mentions that, you know, one is a aparadharma, that is material responsibility. Second is paradharma, that is spiritual responsibility. And third is adharma, that is irresponsibility. So as a devotees, we try to subordinate apara with the para. Right? So as brahmacharis, we may, you know, to great extent give up the, you know, apara dharma, that is material responsibility, and as a grahastha, the partially they may give. But nonetheless, now the, as the setup, you know, goes in the modern time, we all have to, as a brahmacharis also, we are engaged in so many services according to our guna and karma. So that doesn't make much difference. We all are serving together. But these three broad levels of dharma are mentioned. And in the modern time, what happens is people don't even understand what is religion and what is, you know, what is true religion and what is not true religion. That's why even in the Hindu culture or Hindu society today, people think that to, you know, have some nice children and then give them education, get them married and settle them nicely, they think this is dharma. If you ask any Hindu who is an ordinary Hindu, he will say, I am following my dharma. What's wrong with me? Nothing wrong. Certainly this is important. Whatever responsibilities we have got, we have to fulfill them. But this is not the dharma at the para level. That is not the actual spiritual, you know, the potency we have got as a human being. Just like in the Bhagavad Gita, when Arjuna was, you know, denying to fight, then Krishna says that you fight, then better you will go to the heaven. This better enjoyment than heaven. Then further ahead he says that don't bother about heaven, go to the spiritual world, go to the Vaikuntha. Why? Because the potential of the human being is not just, you know, limited within this material world. If you remain within this material world, how much happiness you can get? And that happiness also can be, you know, taken away in due course of time. So better you go to the place where there is eternal happiness, eternal life, like that he says. And therefore, when Krishna, when he comes, you know, when he incarnates, like in the Bhagavad Gita, this fourth chapter, this 7, 8, 9, three shlokas are there. It begins with the yada yadai dharmasya, and then, you know, dharma sansthapanarthaya and all that, to deliver the pious and annihilate the miscreants, he comes. But this is actually not the main reason for what Krishna comes. The main reason is explained in the ninth shloka. You know, those who want to use Bhagavad Gita for secular purpose, they quote these shlokas because they consider that, you know, dharmasya glani in terms of material disorder. Now there is a lot of material disorder in the state. So people think that, you know, there is, you know, corruption, not good government, or people are not, you know, having good culture and this and that. So therefore, you know, God should come and set the order in, you know, proper way for our, you know, so that we can properly enjoy sense gratification. People think like that, those secular, you know, having those secular understanding of Gita. But then the real, you know, meaning of Krishna's descent is explained in the ninth shloka. Therefore, Prabhupada many times, more than 7 and 8, he mentions the ninth shloka. Janma karma chame divyam evam yavyati tatvata. Taktya deham punarjanma neti mameti so Arjuna. Why? Because when we focus on Krishna's janma and karma, and Krishna's janma and karma is not ordinary, if he has to be understood, it has to be understood from the transcendental platform. So therefore, it forces us to go to the spiritual realm to understand it. And then when we see that Krishna, who is, you know, Supreme Personality of Godhead, he is God, when he descends as a small child and he performs many pastimes, that attracts our heart. So if we ordinarily see deities, then it just, he is a God and he is supposed to supply my necessities, we think like that. But if we see in the light of this shloka, Janma Karma Chave Devyam, we'll understand that Krishna is actually not, you know, has come for that, but he has come to, you know, not just come to set the order in this world, but to, you know, take us out of this world so that we know we get the eternal destination. So this you know, it mentions like that. And even if you go to the 11th chapter, when Krishna says that, I have already killed all of them, you just become my instrument. There one point I heard from Chaitanya Charan Prabhu is very nicely presenting it. He says that if Krishna wants, he can do everything for us, right? If he wants to build temple, he can easily build temple. If he wants to distribute books, he can distribute books, lot of books. If he wants to convince someone about him, he can just one, you know, give one small realization within his heart. And that person, you know, can immediately start practicing, which, you know, even big preachers cannot do for him, after investing so much time and, you know, energy in them. Just one small realization given by Krishna. So Krishna can do everything, but still he engages us. Why? Because Krishna is not just concerned for the material result. He is concerned for fixing our consciousness in, you know, him. That's why to fix our consciousness in him, he arranges so many services for us. If there are no services, if Krishna only does everything, then where is opportunity for us to engage our consciousness and thereby get, you know, delivered like that? And this purport, which, you know, 11.33 shloka, that by my arrangement everything will be done, Prabhupada mentions that the whole world is moving according to the plan of the Supreme Lord. Foolish persons who do not have sufficient knowledge think that nature is moving without a plan and all manifestations are but accidental formations. And then he says that thus the battle of Kurukshetra was fought according to the plan of God. Arjuna was refusing to fight, but he was told that he should fight in accordance with the desires of the Supreme Lord. Then he will be happy. If one is in full Krishna consciousness and his life is devoted to Lord's transcendental service, he is perfect. I have one more Prabhupada's quotation in Hindi. He says, not every time it will be, but some, you know, he says that, तो आप कभी कभी इधर आते हैं और चले जाते हैं, इसमें काम नहीं बनेगा, पुस्तक पढ़िए, इससे वेद का ज्ञान लाभ होगा. अपनी बुद्धि से कोशिश करके सुखी होने का जो चेष्टा चल रहा है वो नहीं होगा. कैसे होगा? भोक्ताराम यज्ञ तपसाम. ये जो मेंटल कंकॉक्शन करते हैं कि ये प्लान बनाया जाए तो हम लोग सुखी होंगे, ये प्लान किया जाए तो कभी नहीं होगा, क्योंकि वो मन का प्लान है, भगवान का नहीं. और दुनिया में भगवान का प्लान चलता है, हमारा मन का, तुम्हारा मन का नहीं चलेगा. हमारा प्लान क्या है कि खूब कष्ट करेंगे, अच्छा मकान बनाएंगे, मजे में रहेंगे, कभी नहीं मरेंगे. और भगवान का प्लान है तुमको ये छोड़ना ही पड़ेगा, मरना ही पड़ेगा. तो क्या प्लान बनाओगे? कुछ प्लान नहीं चलेगा. मृत्यु सर्व हरश्च हम, मृत्यु सब तरफ से छीन लेंगे, कुछ नहीं ले जा पाओगे. ऐसे ही आए थे ऐसे ही जाओगे. एक शरीर मिला था और एक शरीर लेना पड़ेगा, ये है प्लान. बस दैवी ऐशी गुणमयी मम माया, ये भगवान की माया का प्लान है, इसको आप अतिक्रमण नहीं कर सकेंगे. दैट इज नॉट पॉसिबल. यू मे ट्राई योर बेस्ट एंड स्ट्रगल, दैट इज नॉट पॉसिबल. तो मामयो प्रपद्यन्ते, जो भगवान का भक्त हो जाते हैं वो फिर कोई प्लान नहीं बनाते. वो कहता है हम आपके चरणों में आपको समर्पित करता हूँ, आपका प्लान चलता है तो जो प्लान आपको बनाना है बनाइए. लाइक दैट ही मेंशंस. सो इट्स वेरी नाइस टू हियर प्रभुपाद्स लेक्चर्स, बिकॉज आई नो what we hesitated to express or tell people, Prabhupada can tell very boldly and very effectively. So all these things, if we tell people don't make plan and this and that, they will you know, smash us. They say, what plan and this and that, how your temple is running, or how you are getting donation, this and that, all the details. But when Prabhupada tells, they have to accept, because that potency is there, like that. And then this is the second point I discussed, that why, you know, it is obligatory, because this is what a human being is supposed to do, and if he doesn't do, then he is, you know, is a miser, not utilizing his assets properly. Third point we'll discuss is the investment. Now after knowing this, if I know that, you know, this is so important, still I hesitate to invest in Krishna. And not just we may be investing, but partially or not fully, having our own, you know, conceptions about how much I can go ahead, how much I can't go ahead in practicing Krishna consciousness. But in general, peer, you know, people, they have this, you know, fear, because Prabhupada, you know, in the one lecture he has given in Bhagavatam, Los Angeles, 1972. He mentions that such a nice, beautiful body, you American boys and girls, nice country, good facilities, no poverty, everything is very nicely given to you. But if in spite of all these facilities, if you don't take Krishna consciousness, then you are Kripana or miser. Miser means one who has got money, but he cannot utilize it. There are many merchants, they get few thousands of dollars from their father, but due to intelligence, he increases to millions of dollars. That is intelligence. So it is a matter of investment. If we invest, then it can increase. But in the investment, there is a factor of risk. So if you are afraid, Are Baba, sab de diya, toh fir humko kya milega? If I invest everything in Krishna, then what I am going to get in return? So it is like, you know, suppose there is a, you know, big, this, what they say, suppose there is a valley. I am on this side of the valley and there is, in between there is a valley. Or, you know, some small, suppose this building and that next building. If I want to jump from this building to that building, then first I will see, can I make, you know, till that building? Can I reach? If I fall in between, what? So same, you know, people think about religion. If I practice religion, will I get anything or will I lose? So when this dilemma is there, and people always choose the path of least resistance. Wherever there is least resistance, you know, they will, you know, go to that side. So they say, better we remain like this. And as a devotee also, as years goes by, if we don't increase our Krishna consciousness, you know, and we don't reach a particular stage where we can get that taste in hearing and chanting and serving, all these doubts will come to us. And one may say that, is there any, you know, way we can check this? That investing in Krishna, I will get the maximum returns. So yes, because as we go on practicing, we get, you know, some small, you know, what do you say, installments of, you know, mercy of Krishna. We experience the transformation in our heart. We experience the change in our heart. And see, and this can continue if we regulate ourselves, if we discipline ourselves. Therefore, the second point comes is, you know, if we maintain ourselves in the mode of goodness, then only we can realize that yes, I am getting something, and if I continue practicing, I will get even more. And if in between I stop, then the fall is inevitable. Like if somebody is in the lift and he has, you know, reached the, you know, 60th floor or 50th floor, from there he, you know, jumps suddenly, then he will naturally meet accident, right? There is no way he can be saved. So like that, if we go up and suddenly we, you know, start forgetting everything. In the very beginning we, you know, quoted this shloka that our hearing and chanting will stop. One of the reason is we commit the offenses. Lord withdraws the mercy. So we have to check whether I have become, you know, proud, or I have become, you know, careless in following the regulative principles. And if we, you know, analyze that, we can come to know. So like that, there are, you know, small, you know, Krishna gives this, you know, glimpse of happiness you are getting ahead as we go. But if we are not careful and if we don't maintain our discipline and regularity, especially in the morning program, because morning program is the time when we, you know, at least we do activities in the mode of goodness. And that activities, you know, those activities in the mode of goodness will, you know, give us reserve stock of goodness which can be utilized throughout the day. Because as the day starts, you know, we will definitely go into some activities which are passion oriented, right? So that time, passion, instead of controlling us, if we are in goodness, we can utilize that passion. Therefore, this time of the day, especially the morning time, is very important. Otherwise, you know, we start getting the doubts. Am I getting anything? You know, will I get in the further? Because the one symptom of mode of goodness is, you know, it gives the discrimination what is right, what is wrong. So after some time, if we you know, are not able to maintain that, then we'll just confused whether I'm doing right, whether I'm doing wrong. So we have to check, you know, come back and check whether my sadhana and everything is all right or not. So like that, this is regarding, you know, the investment. And even if we see our regular, you know, if we regularly read scriptures, we get a lot of things to know. There are many things, but I may not be able to cover. So I'll go to the last point, that is, what are the four requirements for investing in Krishna? This comes in the Bhagavad Gita, 5th chapter, 17th shloka. It says that, tad buddhayas tadatmanas tan nishta tat parayana gacchanti apunar avrittim nan nirdhuta kalmasham. He says that these four faculties of our consciousness we have to engage. First is intelligence, second is mind, third is faith, and fourth is refuge. All four are required. And he gives many examples, like, suppose initially we may have intelligence, and by intelligence we may engage. And we may understand, okay, this is required, this is essential, this is not essential. But then, is our mind cooperating with us? We may understand the value of chanting and the value of associating with the devotees, but is our mind there? Mind may not be there. So then next we have to put our mind. And then third, even if our intelligence is there, mind is there, do I have faith? Because there are many students who study for exam, right? They engage their intelligence, their mind is there, but they don't have faith in that. Ek padhai karna hai, khatam karna hai. Or many researcher or scientist, they at the end of the day they want some money. That is their goal of life is not, you know, to, you know, engage themselves wholeheartedly in that. So their intelligence is engaged, their mind is engaged, but they don't have faith. Chaitanya Charitamrita was quoting one example of academic scholar, especially religious academic scholars, they have this tendency. Their intelligence is there, their mind is there, but what they speak, they don't have faith at all. Then he says, use one example of, you know, scholar of the Bible, one Christian. Maharaj, you know, Maharaj meets him, and this person, he had given a lot of, you know, talks on the TV shows and written many articles and books. And he sees, Maharaj, he says, this Jew boy has become Hare Krishna. Then he debates with Maharaj. And then Maharaj, you know, kind of gives, you know, from Bhagavad Gita various things, and he gets defeated. I don't know if Maharaj is hearing if he but this example I'm just telling to demonstrate that. And then he says that, you know, after hearing all this, at the third day, this person, he says that, well, as far as I am concerned, you are very convinced about your this thing, but as far as I am concerned, I don't believe whether Jesus existed or not. Maharaj says, what? He said, I have a doubt. Then he says, then why did you, you know, give all these, you know, TV shows, talks and books? He says that this is my profession. And then he says, why did you debate with me for 3 days? He says, this is my entertainment. So like that, these people, they can get everything, you know, through their intelligence and engaging their mind, but their faith is not there in that. And finally, even after having faith, are we wholeheartedly engaging in that? The fourth thing comes, the refuge. In Bhagavatam, there are many examples, like Shukracharya. He was intelligent, he was engaging his mind, and he had faith in the Vedic scriptures, but when it comes to giving, you know, donation to Vamanadev, he, you know, refrains from that, and even he stops his own disciple, right? Other example, there is an example of Durvas Muni. He goes to Vaikuntha, but he doesn't say, Vishnu, that, you know, please deliver me from all these anarthas and liberate me and bring to the Vaikuntha planets. Another example, he gives the Pururava Maharaj, and he conducts yajna for Lord Vishnu. Lord Vishnu comes, and he asks Vishnu for Urvashi. So see, these examples are there in our Vedic tradition also, that they have intelligence, their mind is there, they have faith in the process also, but their heart is not there. The full refuge is not there. And this is even more dangerous for devotees because we all come from very intellectual background, right? And with intelligence, we take the full, you know, hold of the Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita and everything. And especially our place is known for intellectually oriented classes and, you know, some acronym lesson, this, that. So many things we give many times. But if you are not careful in the sense that we, you know, can do all these things, but we have to filter, you know, everything through this process. That although I have everything, you know, I can quote many shlokas and I can arrange a nice systematic presentation, I can speak, but is my heart is there, full refuge is there? Then only, basically, this shloka is the elaboration of 4.9, Janma Karma Chavi Divyam. The Divya aspect of Krishna can be understood when he reveals, you know, only when he reveals, then only we can understand. Otherwise, just at the material platform. And that revelation can come only when we have full refuge in him, wholeheartedly, without keeping even, you know, a small thing with us, like that. So this way, if we go, then we can practice nicely Krishna consciousness. I'll end with one, you know, Prabhupada's quotation in Hindi. He says that, if we don't understand Krishna, what will happen? He says, Krishna ek lampat hai, gopi ke saath naashta hai, maja karta hai, bas itna hi suna hai, kyunki yahi sunaya jata hai. Hamare jo bhagavat pathak hote hain, wo pehle hi raslila Krishna ko samjhaye nahi, pehle hi raslila bata dete hain. Bahut aadmi humko prashna karte hain ki aapka Krishna to aisa karta hai, waisa karta hai. 16,000 stri rakha hai. To main jawab deta hoon ki agar bhagwan hai Krishna to 16,000 क्या अगर 16 करोड़ शादियां कर ले तो इससे इसके लिए क्या जाता है आखिर भगवान है भुक्ता राम विद्य तपसम अगर भगवान भुक्ता है तो वही तो भोग करने वाला है तुम जो एक स्त्री रखे हो वही तुम्हारा चोरी है यह जवाब मैं देता हूं ही सुप्रीम एंजॉयर देन एवरीथिंग शुड बी एंजॉयड बाय हिम यू आर नॉट एंजॉयर तो कारण यही है कि कृष्ण को तात्विक समझाया नहीं गया इसीलिए यह सारा दुनिया में कृष्ण को कोई कुछ कहता है कोई कुछ कहता है औजानंति माम मूढ़ा बोका गधा लोग जो है वो कृष्ण को अवज्ञा करते हैं और नरक में जाते हैं ये परिस्थिति है सो इफ वी डोंट टेक फुल रिफ्यूज इन कृष्णा दैट रिवेलेशन इज नॉट देयर दैट रिवेलेशन इज नॉट देयर वी मिसअंडरस्टैंड कृष्णाज पास्ट टाइम एंड इवन द होल प्रोसेस ऑफ कृष्णा कॉन्शियसनेस सो आई बेग फॉरगिवनेस फॉर एनीथिंग स्पोकन वेरी यू नो इम्प्रॉपरली आई एम जस्ट कोटिंग प्रभुपाद बिकॉज वी नीड टू हियर दैट सम टाइम Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Srimad Bhagavat Purana ki jai.